Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here. Just about 10:15 in Honolulu, 4:15 in New York. It is Thursday, June 30th, 2016, and we are looking at the Dow Jones Industrial Average with three superlative upside days, pretty much accounting for all or the majority of the drawdown that we saw after the Brexit vote. Dow Jones Industrial Average up 235 points, just shy of that elusive 18,000 again at 17,929. Standard & Poor's also up over 8% on the day, 2088.50. It traded to a high of 91 and change and a low on the day of 2056. An incredible comeback for U.S. equities. So traders, once again, we see U.S. equities staging a tremendous comeback after falling out of bed just following, of course, the Brexit vote. The Brexit vote, which came in on Thursday, the following day, this would be Friday, this long red candle, took the market from just below 2120 and plunged it to an intraday low at 2000, only to close at about 2020, which was just above the 200-day moving average and just above the 38% retracement. Now, on the following day, it continued to track lower, this being Monday of this week, and the market actually settled down well below the 200-day moving average and touched upon the 50% retracement level at 1976. Now, the rest is history in terms of what we've seen. This is Thursday, of course, Wednesday, and Tuesday's trading session. On Tuesday, the market really began to recuperate. Real strong day, I believe that was a 300-point rise in the Dow Jones Industrial Average. That was followed yesterday by a 260-plus point rise, and then today's rise is well over 200. Now, as I said at the beginning of the report, we have given back, or gotten back, I should say, much of the lost ground that happened, but also realized that at that point, we had U.S. equities trading near some recent highs, which would be about 2122, not necessarily the all-time highs of last year, but certainly the all-time highs that it achieved this year. We are now well above the 50-day moving average. We broke through that today. So over the last 3 days, we have seen U.S. equities, which lost, I believe, in excess of $2 trillion in value, probably gain back at least $1.5 trillion of that lost value. The difference between where the market is now, which is roughly at 2090, and where it began to fall, which is roughly 2110, call it, is that differential. And that differential is not going to be that hard to be made up if we maintain this bullish tract. So traders, I've gone ahead and converted that daily chart that we were looking at into a weekly chart. And a couple of things that I do want to point out when we look at it in this way. First of all, the retracement that I have been working with is this particular band or area here. I have pegged the low right here at 1831, and of course the high at 2122. There are highs. These are the all-time highs coming in right in here. And as you can see on a weekly chart, we are fairly close to that particular price point. And the other thing that I believe is exceptional to look at is the kind of move that we have seen this week. Of course, we still have 1 day of trading left. Next week will be a shortened week due to the 4th of July holiday here in the United States. And if you recall from just prior to the Brexit vote, I had gone on record saying that if in fact it passed, we would see a dramatic decline in the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and that should be looked at as an opportunity to buy. I never put out an official trade alert recommending a long position, but I am hoping that subscribers out there took that advice and were able to profit from it. Traders, lastly, a quick look at crude oil. Crude oil actually down today, $1.50 per barrel or 3% in terms of the net loss on the day, currently trading at $48.39. And the one thing that we can say is that there is that disassociation now between the price of crude oil and the price of equities, because as you can see, we've had three dramatic days in which equities have gotten stronger, two of which we saw oil getting stronger, only to kind of have that correlation change today to a negative correlation. In other words, we had crude oil down, but that did not affect the bullish sentiment in the market in U.S. equities, as we saw U.S. equities continue to rise. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. Talk to you tomorrow for another daily update and review in trending markets. Bye-bye.